Welcome to the last week of the course. In this week's lectures, we will discuss the relevance of value-sensitive design to responsible innovation. Responsible innovation without a more detailed conception of how to use moral values to shape technology will miss the point and lack efficacy. Historically, computer science has been the discipline in which value-sensitive design was developed, although the idea has a much wider purchase in technology. When the computer was introduced, around the middle of the 20th century, scholarly attention focused on the new technology itself. The digital computer was correctly seen by many as a general-purpose technology that could provide solutions to a wide range of problems. There was little attention for the social context and the users of computing machinery at that first stage. In the second stage of the development of the computer, in the 70s and 80s, people started to realize that computers had to be used in real organizations, supporting real human users with specific needs and requirements in different work environments and social and institutional settings. The social and behavioral sciences became then increasingly involved with information technology in the form of human-computer interaction, participatory design, and social informatics. This shift to social context, usage, and users, however, was primarily motivated by attempts to identify potential barriers to the successful implementation of systems and to prevent failures and failed investments. In any case, it led to the study of user-friendliness, usability, and user acceptance. In a third stage, around the turn of the 21st century, the successful application of information technology was gradually seen as dependent on its capacity to accommodate a much broader range of human values than user-friendliness. Human beings, whether in their role as employers, employees, consumers, citizens, or patients, have moral values, moral preferences, and moral ideals. In every society, there are ongoing moral public debates about equality, property, privacy, sustainability, autonomy, and accountability. When and whether appropriate our computer systems should accommodate these values. In the last decade, values have emancipated from the status of mere constraints in implementation to constitutive aims and driving factors in the development of IT. In California, a Center for IT in the Interest of Society, CITRIS, was founded. We seem to have entered a fourth phase in the development of IT where the needs and values of human users as citizens, patients, are considered in their own right, and IT is conceived of as a technology to serve and support human beings qua moral persons in their moral and social endeavors. We have moved from mere technology via technology in social context and moral values as constraints to technology at the service of society. This development is neatly summarized in the term value-sensitive design that gained currency in the last decade, and that is the topic of this week's web lectures. The core idea of value-sensitive design is that moral values can be expressed in engineering design and that we can impart the fruits of our ethical reflection concerning sustainability, safety, and privacy to the things we design and make. We will look at that origin of this idea and discuss how, in the last decades of the 20th century, several lines of research have contributed to this idea. And in the next web lecture, we will discuss the converging lines of thought and research in more detail. Thank you for your attention.